Some of you might remember about a month ago we recorded a video with this one. It's cesium. It's the emperor of alkali metals. But you know, we've been looking at the YouTube feedback and we've been really astonished with the number of people that are one, interested in the science, and two, really want to egg us on to do something a little bit mad. So unfortunately I'm not going to put this into water today because it's far too expensive. But what I did do was that me and Neil had a look at the chemicals purchasing database at the university, and we spent about £60 of our own hard-earned money to buy a small sample of cesium, which, yes, you guessed it, we're going to throw into water today.
Many people get quite excited about cesium because they've seen a very famous video which predates YouTube, but I think now is seen many places, in which somebody drops a tiny piece of cesium into water and it explodes enough to break the vessel that the cesium is in.
So some of you have noticed the stoic Neil Barnes, our senior technician on the project. And Neil's been really, really busy. Last Friday, he designed and built a specific piece of apparatus to liberate the cesium from its glass surroundings or its vial.
You pull the string, and then you let it go.
Some of you might have heard of this like large hadron collider that they've got in Switzerland in CERN. This is actually a small metallic collider that we're going to use to liberate cesium and study some of its chemistry.
And the reason that cesium is so reactive is that the atoms of cesium are very large, much larger than rubidium, sodium and potassium, and so the reaction with water, which removes an electron from the cesium atom, is much easier because it needs less energy. So if there's less energy needed to remove the electron from the cesium, then there's more energy left to release as heat.
So we're behind the boiler shed, which is out the back of the department, simply because it allows us to control the environment a little bit more. So, back by popular demand, cesium Mark II. We have a gram of cesium in a glass vial. We have our remote control device. Let's see what happens when we put it into water. We've actually got some students watching.
I don't know, perhaps they rigged their original experiment to explode the thing, but this has become a classic. And I think many of our viewers expect us to have a bigger and better explosion than they did.
So here's our cesium sitting in the bottom of the little tube. And now we're going to actuate the small metallic collider to initiate the reaction. So time for the safety, and let's see what happens. Ready, guys?
I've never seen cesium react with water, and it might be quite exciting.
Well, you could see it was a very vigorous reaction, and the whole of that gram of cesium reacted instantaneously the moment it hit the water. Nice purple flare, really quite nice chemistry.